Love is but a song we sing. Fears that we will die. You can make the mountains ring or make the angels cry. Though the bird is on the wing and you may not know why. Come on, people now, smile on your brother. Everybody get together.
Good evening, Highland Valley, and welcome to The Journey tonight. We're going to talk about loving our neighbor. The scripture lesson tonight is from Matthew 5, verses 38 through 48. You have heard that it was said, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth, but I say to you that you must not oppose those who want to hurt you. If people slap you on the right cheek, you must turn the left cheek to them as well. When they wish to haul you to court and take your shirt, let them have your coat too. When they force you to go 1 mile, go with them too. Give to those who ask, and don't refuse those who wish to borrow from you. You have heard that it was said, you must love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But I say to you, love your enemies and pray for those who harass you, so that you will be acting as children of your Father who is in heaven. He makes the sun rise on both the evil and the good, and sends rain on both the righteous and the unrighteous. If you only love those who love you, what reward do you have? Don't even the tax collectors do the same? And if you greet only your brothers and sisters, what more are you doing? Don't even the Gentiles do the same? Therefore, just as your heavenly Father is complete in showing love to everyone, so also you must be complete. This is the word of God for us, the people of God. Thanks be to God. Will you bow with me for prayer? Holy and loving God, it is so difficult for us to love others, to love our enemies, to do your will in our lives. It's so difficult for us to even comprehend what it means to give away all that we have so that we can serve you more fully and be more like our Savior Jesus. But we pray, Lord, that you will give us the strength and the courage to do your will and to continue on this journey to be perfected in your love. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
You are the Word at the beginning, one with God, the Lord Most High. Your hidden glory in creation, now great your love.
Good evening, Highland Valley and honored guest. We are thankful you're joining us tonight for The Journey.
Tonight, we carry on with our series, Foundations, Instructions for Life. These are Jesus' words from the Sermon on the Mount that teach us how to be Christians.
Yeah. Last week, we read about the blessings that we can count on if we follow Jesus' example. And this week, we continue with learning what Jesus had to say about our neighbors. And the first thing I always do with the kids that's probably helpful to everyone is I have them think about what their neighbor is. And when I think of neighbor, the first thing I think of are the people that live right next to me on either side. But it's so many more people than that if you think about what Jesus meant by that word, neighbor.
Right, right. So think back to the Pharisee who asked Jesus, who is my neighbor? Mm-hmm. Jesus responded by telling the parable of the Good Samaritan. When Jesus told about the three men that walked by, the priest and the Levite and the Samaritan, of whom only the Samaritan helped and even paid for the injured man a place at the inn to be taken care of, he asked, who was the neighbor? When the Pharisee responded, the man who showed mercy, Jesus said, go and do likewise.
Yeah, it makes sense. It's not about really who's in close proximity to us.
Right.
In Jesus's commandment, he taught us that it's not about who our neighbor is, rather our willingness to help. Our neighbor can be a perfect stranger.
Right. But this can be difficult, though, like to love the neighbor gossiping about you in the parking lot, to love the neighbor who is not kind to you at all, to love the neighbor that speaks out against the people that you love. How can we be like Jesus? Mm-hmm. And love people that don't show us love, to be fair to people that aren't fair to us, to be nice to people that aren't nice to us. I always think about scripture and about how it's easy to love the people who love you. How do you love the people that don't love you?
Right. And it's, for me, it's not only hard, it can be very intimidating, depending on your neighbor. So tonight we hope to give you some easy first steps to love your neighbor. And this is from, these ideas are from an article I read from Holly Mathewa, maybe.
Wow.
Forgive your neighbor, Holly, if I pronounced your name wrong. I apologize.
Yeah. Definitely. So the first thing you can do is see your neighbor. Many times we are blinded by our own agenda. I talk about that a lot.
Yeah,
like we get caught up in our own personal agenda so much. And then do we know, like, what are we talking about? Are we trying to do God's will? Are we trying to do our own? So open your eyes and see your neighbor. Mm-hmm. Like, we got to get past our own agenda. We have to get past our own opinion, our own hurt or attitude. But we must look past all that. Look past the outer shell and look into their eyes, into their heart. Consider their side. We have to see that neighbor as God does.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And when I think of see, that also makes me think of slow down. I mean, we're busy. We may drive right by someone that needs help and not notice it. We've had, the first step is to really see your neighbors. And that's great advice. See your neighbors the way that God sees. And if we pray for that daily, I don't see how we can't love others.
Right.
I mean, if that's your sincere prayer every day. The second first step you can take to love your neighbor is to ask for forgiveness and offer forgiveness. And Holly said this beautifully in her article, and she says, and I'm going to quote her, "I'll ask forgiveness for the strongholds within my own heart that keep me from sympathizing with or loving one another. If I'm closed off or indifferent toward a person or group of people, I'll ask forgiveness before the Lord and from my neighbor."
Yeah, I think that's a part that some of us miss. It's important to me. Not only ask for and forgive others, but that confession to the Lord, I mean, that's powerful. Mm-hmm. And that can really get you going down that path of, you know, sometimes you talk to God and then you can then maybe take that next step and talk to others. So to seek and ask for the Lord's help when you need it.
Yeah.
The third step you can take to love your neighbor is pray. We went right into that. That worked out perfectly.
Yeah.
So to me, this is the easiest in some ways. It's non-confrontational. You don't have to see the person if you're not ready. Pray for that person, that group, and also for yourself. So it can be easy, but you have to make a conscious effort to do it. And you have to be mindful, and you have to get in that routine and do it daily.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So we can see the people. We can offer and ask for forgiveness and pray. And another thing we can do to love our neighbors is to rejoice and mourn with them. We can walk alongside them when they're mourning, and we can celebrate with them during their times of joy. And I was thinking Highland Valley does this really better than anyone that I know. We know we're in it together, whatever it may be, whatever we're going through, we know we don't go through it alone. We have pastors, Sunday school classes, small groups, circles of care that are right there with us and everything. And mm-hmm. and I was thinking, but not just in our church, also in our community. Mm-hmm. Like our food pantry is an excellent example of walking together when people are mourning, you know, right. when people are in need, and being there for them, but also rejoicing. I mean, we have people that come by that will sit in their car and just talk to us. So right. I really feel proud of Highland Valley for living out that example mm-hmm. of loving your neighbor.
All right. And that's what drew us to this church originally mm-hmm. is the love that you feel from our community. It just feels like a little small town church that's built on love. So I think we're getting a lot of things right. We just have to be mindful and continue to work towards it. But the other thing that we can do also is to love our neighbors is to learn and be teachable. Mm. This can be hard. Christ's ways are hard and challenging, and we are selfish. This is a me mm-hmm. society, mm-hmm. and everyone is always telling us to look out for ourselves. But that's not what Jesus teaches. He teaches something a little bit different. And I said this in Sunday school just the other day, that most of the time, and I don't think I'm alone here, I think I'm right. I don't know if you do that or everyone else does or not, but like I think as humans, it's our instinct, for especially when we're in an argument or a discussion or mm-hmm. having a problem, you know, with someone or something, we think that we're right. Yeah. We think that we've got it all figured out.
Well, and we know our intentions. It may not come across right, the right way, true. But that for me, that's knowing I'm right. Like I didn't mean it that way. You have to know I didn't mean it that way, or you know, something like that.
Yeah. So even though I go into these situations like assuming I'm right and I know everything, and I know I don't know everything, but it's that's your deep down inside. That's what.
Did everyone hear him say that? He does not know everything.
Believe it or not, but we do feel that way. At least, like you said, and it may be in our intentions. Maybe what's coming out is something different. But deep down, we kind of feel like we feel like we're doing the right thing, but we're not always doing the right thing, and we don't always know what's best. And one of the hardest things that we can do as Christians is to get past that. You don't learn from talking. Mm-hmm. We learn from listening. Right. So I have to allow my neighbors to challenge me and to teach me to be moldable and to accept criticism. That can be very difficult.
Very difficult.
And so I cannot love my neighbor while acting like I know it all.
Right. Christ's ways are challenging, and it's hard to love someone that you don't agree with, and it's hard to love someone that continually shows the opposite to you or to a group of people, but we're called to be like Christ, right. to love our neighbors as ourselves. So think this week what that means to you, Highland Valley.
Yeah, and pray. We're in a time of division, of picking sides, so much polarization, information overload that may not always be accurate. We're in a pandemic, secluded, lonely, away from our church and family. Neighbors seem farther away than ever. Peace seems farther away than ever. Mm-hmm. But if we follow this advice, maybe it's a start.
Yeah, and this is a process. And I'm always diligently praying for my neighbor. I want the best for everyone. I want a multitude of blessings for everyone in the world. But if it's a bad situation, I may not be ready for the rest just yet. Right. I may have a hard time forgiving at first if I'm right in the middle of all that hurt. And I may not be able to walk beside you because some trust has been broken. And I may not feel comfortable learning from you because maybe our initial interaction was a little bit confrontational or accusatory or whatever at the beginning. So we want you to know that this can be a process. If you're thinking about these things, well, I can do this, I can't do that. I mean, no one is judging anybody by that. We know that this is a process. It takes a while sometimes. And I think it's definitely my mission in life to love as Christ did. So all of these are great steps to take for yourself and for your heart and for your attitude and for others. But it may not be easy, and it may not happen all at once.
No, definitely not easy. Like you said, this is a process. It's all a process. If it was easy, everybody would be doing it and doing it really well. Mm-hmm. But it's knowing that we have these steps that we can take to kind of get through it. I don't know. It's just not something that's easy. And it's just because we're saying it doesn't mean that we're always doing it.
Right.
We're trying. We're striving as Christians, but we will fail some. Mm-hmm. But as long as we know that, you know, what our goal is and what it is that God is calling us to do.
And I like that these steps kind of start out small. Like, yes, there are places in the world where awful things are happening, and I may not have the tools to go help those neighbors, but I can start out small.
Right.
There are things that I can educate myself on that, or I can pray about that, or donate to that, or whatever the case may be.
Right.
I think for us, loving your neighbor, what we're trying to say is just start out small.
Yeah.
If that's all you've got, then that's what God's given you. Just use it.
Yeah.
Start out small.
Exactly. Yeah. So hopefully these tools will be helpful. Let's go out into the world, Highland Valley. Let's be Christians. Let's do what God called us to do. Let's do what Jesus has called us to do. Mm-hmm. Let's love our neighbor. And if we can keep that as our foundation, I think that we can get through it all.
Amen.
All right. We'll see you back next week.
The beauty of the King, you make righteous those who seek, you have written and redeemed my story. Let my eyes see your King shine all around. Let my heart overflow with passion for your name. Let my life be a song revealing who you are. For you are salt and light. Oh, the love that set me free. You bring hope to those in need. You have written and redeemed my story. Let my eyes see your King shine all around. Let my heart overflow with passion for your name. Let my life be a song revealing who you are. For you are salt and light, you are love's great height. You are deep and wide, a consuming fire. You are salt and light, you are love's great height. You are deep and wide, a consuming fire. Let my eyes see your kingdom shine all around. Let my heart overflow with passion for your name. Let my life be a song revealing who you are. For you are salt and light. You are salt and light. For you are salt and light. For you are salt and light.
Smile on your brother, everybody get together.